Hey, it's Martha from Just Martha Designs, and you're going to want to go grab a punch and come back and tune in, because guess what? We have something really special to do today, and you're going to want to see this. We're going to create our own designer paper. So stay tuned, because the video is coming up. When we use a punch, and for example, this is the Daisy punch that came with my Daisy Delight bundle, we often have bits and pieces running around that look a little bit like this. And so I was thinking, I need to find a way to utilize the little punch out area. So today is all about scraps again, and we're going to be using a punch, part of the punch out, to create a new and different card. And so the first thing that I want to start with is I'm going to take just a sheet like this, and I'm going to be using the little punch out. And so what I will do is I will take my punch out, and I'm going to be creating my own paper. And in order to do this, I will need a little finger dauber sponge, if you will. And I have this one, and this one has already been used. It's been used in a darker, but that's okay, because I'm going to use that as well. And I'm going to be building up some colors on here. And what I really want to do is I will start with some lighter colors. And I will be building my way up. And so I have my crushed curry, I have some Cajun craze, and I have some powder pink. And I think I may even get into the cherry cobbler, I'm not sure. But I'm going to start with the lighter colors, and in this instance, it's going to be the powder pink. First, give it a little squeeze. All right, so I'm going to start with the powder pink and my little finger dauber, and I have placed my paper underneath the little cutout of the Daisy, and I'm going to kind of just color in using this like it's a stencil. I think I'm going to have to get a little more ink on there. Some more off the pad. There we go. All right, and so I'm going to put it really dark in the center. And so there's my first one. I'm going to move this over. That little piece popped up. And I'm going to do another one. Dark in the center. And then kind of sponge around. This should go a little quicker. And then I will move this again. And this time I want to go to another color. I'm gonna do my crushed curry. And this will probably end up looking a little more orange. And I'm gonna stamp center and then kind of brush it in, daub a little. Got more coverage out of this one than I did the pink. Like that. Move this again. Some more color. Really dark to the center. And I think I like the way the yellow covers better than I do the pink. All right. So, now, moving right along, I'm going to take my crepe. Ooh, boy, that. Take my Cajun craze. Open it up. Want to get on the little sponge. Alright. And I'm going to do this the same way. Dark to the center. And kind of sweep it in. Move it on around. Up a little more pigment, dark in the center, sweep it in, like so. I really need a lighter color there. Right. And I'm going to use my cherry cobbler. Usually gives me a lot more color. Alright. Pick that color up. Get that center nice and dark. Sweep it in. Try this yellow one more time. Alright, so now that I have like the color, on there, I can turn around and use this as a background design if I want to and cut it up. And that's how you can create your own paper and your own designer paper using nothing more than a stencil.
How easy was that? Just using a punch and some ink, we created our own designer paper. And speaking of easy, celebration is going on right now. And it's going on until March 31st, and it's easy to earn free stamps. For every $50 that you spend, you get a free item. Spend $100, get two $50 or one of the $100 items that are in here. And it's free. It's easy. Just like the designer paper. Take advantage of celebration going on now. See the link in the description box below. Bye.